So you're probably an HVAC business owner, a designer, or even a marketing agency that helps HVAC companies, and you want to create amazing HVAC ads for Facebook and Instagram that convert into leads. Usually, creating great ads for heating and air conditioning companies takes a lot of time. But using Canva, you can save hours from your work by knowing how to create HVAC ads using Canva. So in this video, I'm gonna show you the secret to how we structure and design an HVAC ad for Facebook and Instagram using the methods we discovered with the tens of thousands of ads we've designed. We've never shared these secrets before. Hi, I'm Kerry, one of the founders here at HVAC Grow. When we started HVAC Grow, it took us 77 different designs before we discovered what worked. Now let's jump over to my computer and you can watch over my shoulder as I design an HVAC ad using Canva in less than 20 minutes. Okay, today I'm going to show you how to design an HVAC ad in, or heating and air conditioning ad in Canva for Facebook, for Instagram. The techniques we're going to use here are, and strategies, are ones we've never shared with anybody else. And this design is based on the tens of thousands of ads that we've created for our clients and what works for them and what has got the most leads. So there is a specific format that works best that we found, and I am going to use that to design this ad right in front of you here from scratch and show you how to do it, how to use Canva to do it, and how you can make a great looking HVAC ad. So first thing we're going to do is we're here in Canva. I'm going to go create design, and I'm going to go down to either Instagram Reel. So I'll just go Instagram, actually not Reel, post. Because what you want, or there's, you want a square. So Instagram post square, which is 1080 by 1080. I'm going to do that first. And always good to name it right away so you know what you're looking for and be descriptive. So I'm just going to say heating and AC system, a mega sale example. Whoops, so I can spell it right. Next thing is we want to have a background. So there are a number of colors that work very well for backgrounds. We found that blue with some red on it works really, really, really well. So I'm going to just go and I'm going to do a blue background, search for that. I'm going to click on graphics and I'm going to find a nice blue background. Let's go something like this. Yeah, I like that one. Make it that. And then I'm going to add a little bit of decoration on top of it. So it's not just blue, just something that gives a little bit more pop. So I'm just going to do a search for celebration. And we don't want to use anything here that's got motion graphics because this is just going to be a static image ad. And let's see here. Let's see what this one looks like. No, let's not go that one. How about this one? Oh, some stars. Great. Let's do that. Pull that out to fit. And then that's a little bit too much, but I still like it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce the transparency on it so that it's still subtle, but it just adds a little bit more to the blue background. So let's just go like 30% on this one. And next thing is I want to find a heading. So we're going to call this a mega sale. So I'm just going to go to mega sale. And you want to make sure you're on elements here. And I've got graphics. I'm going to look through here and I'm going to find one I like. Let's just see quickly here. And come on, let's find some. Oh, here we go. Let's go with this one. And we don't want it to go where it's filling in there like that. Don't do that for me. Oops, did that. What I'm going to do here is I'm just going to group this so that way I can get this so it's not jumping all over the place on me here. As you can see, what's happening is it's filling in that background. And I don't want that, obviously. And that's because I've got that there. So I'm just going to pull this here, get that in here. Pull that back up here. There we go. So take that. I think I'll reduce it a bit. Just throw it in the middle for now. I'm going to have to resize that anyway. Next thing is that we want to put a heading on here. So I'm just going to hit the T button on the keyboard so you get text. And I'm going to say exactly what this is, heating and AC system. Like that. Let's move it up here because we want it at the top. What we found is that seeing what this ad is about right away at the top gets the best results because when people scroll, they're scrolling, you're going to see the top of this first. So let's tell them exactly what this ad is about to grab their attention. So I'm going to get a nice condensed font here. Something like, let's just see here. I'm just going to do league because I know that one's nice and condensed. And it's already bold. And then I'm going to give it an effect so we get a bit of a curve on it. So that's obviously way too much of a curve, but I can fix that, go back to effects, and I'm going to pull this down a bit, something like that. So it's not so crazy. I'm going to size it up. Whoops. Why did it do that? Let's go back. Let's get this down here a bit. Jumped around on me. Stop jumping around on me. There we are. Okay, now I'm going to size this up. Fill as much space as I can at the top. That's looking good. All right. So, got a nice big heading at the top that people will see. Let's give it a bit of an effect as well to make it stand out even more. So, let's go neon. Let's change it to red. Now, if I go back to the effects and I turn down the intensity, you get a red glow on the outside, but the text stays white, which really makes it pop on top of the background. I like that just like that. That looks good to me. And then I'm just going to pull this up a little closer. Let's just make sure this is centered. So you could do that by going here. Yep, it's centered. So if it's grayed out like that, it means it's already centered. And that's the same with this. If you look here, oh, no, there we are, centered. Okay, so we've got that centered. Let's give this mega sale a little bit more of a pop. So I'm going to go over here, just look for celebration. And you can come up with many things that you want to search for here because there's so much artwork that it has. And I'm just looking for something to give it, oh, make it look a little bit. Here we go. Let's go with this. Now, some of this artwork you can get in Canva, you can change the colors on. So I want these stars to be gold. Let's just use this here. And then this is going to be red. There we go. Let's make it like this. Go over here. Let's turn it like so. It's probably a bit big. Let's size it down. There we go. That gives it just a little bit more pop. Turn it a bit more. Like that. There we go. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate it. And then I am going to turn it around. Like so. Move it in a bit closer. There. Now we've really made this mega sale pop a bit. Move it up a bit here. You could see it's like boom, right in your face. Now, the next thing is you want to put equipment in the ad. We found that putting the equipment in there really makes a difference as well. So I'm just going to go quickly show you how I can get some equipment. So I just went over here and I went American Standard HVAC, went to tools and I went large because it needs to be big enough to fill so it doesn't look all pixelated. So I went through and I wanted to find something where we just had a furnace and an air conditioner, which I found, which I clicked here. Oops, where did it go now? I just had it, it's right over here. So here it is. Here's a nice, really cool thing you do. I'm just going to right click and go copy image. Go back over here and paste it. Now, it does have a background, white background. That's okay. Great thing about Canva, edit photo, remove background, and watch what happens. There we go. Background's removed. That's so fast. Back years ago, we'd have to go do this in Photoshop and manually hand crop it, but now it's even better. So now we want to put the price on here. And the thing what you can do with the price, let's just go look for price bar or price tag. Let's look at price tag and let's find something that kind of stands out. So I'm just keep scrolling here to find something that really catches my attention and something like we're going to find, oh, here we go. Let's do this because we can do this with this. Let's put it here. Let's have it attached to the mega sale. It'll go right above the air conditioning unit and let's put it here like so. So it kind of looks like it's all attached and together. That's what we want. Now we want to put a price on here. We're going to make this a monthly financing price. So again, I'm just going to hit T on the keyboard. And I'm going to go one. I'm just going to go 119. Let's say 119 a month. It can be whatever price you want. I'm just using that as an example. Let's italicize this because it's going to be on an angle. And then let's turn it like so. And that's starting to look good. Let's make that bigger. Like that. Then let's take this and we're going to put per month beside it. So here we go. I'm going to have to make this smaller. So I'm just going to make it down to about 56 for now. I can adjust it later. We're going to left justify it. Let's make it all caps here. Now there's too much line space here. So I'm just going to select it all, which I just did Control or Command A on your keyboard. Change the line spacing. And I'm going to move this over a bit so it lines up nicer. Now, obviously, it's still too big. Size that down. pull it down here. That's looking good. So you got per month there. I don't think I need to make any more changes on that. I think that stands out nicely. Maybe get rid of one of the spaces I put in here. Oh yeah, that's better. And maybe not. Let's go back, put that in. There we go. Now, the next thing is we got to put the dollar sign. The one little thing I don't like about Canva is that it's hard to do what you call superscript. So this, the dollar sign being a bit smaller and not in line to the top. So I'm just going to take this, copy it, paste it. You can even do it this way too. You can go like this and you can go duplicate and go over here, put the dollar sign in. I'm just going to reduce the space there and then I'm going to size it up. Move it over and maybe in a bit more. And there we are. We've got the price right there. Okay. So what we want to do now is we want to say starting at only. So I kind of want it to look different than the rest of the text in here because it's not as important, still important to have it in. So I'm just going to put a T again. I'm going to say starting. Let's make this white to begin with. And I'll move it over here. And we'll say start. Oh, I got all caps on. And at only, let's make this right justified. And let's find a nice script font. I know. So you can, here's the thing you can do in Canva. You can say script. And let's just see here. I'm going to look for one that I know that it's good. So you can see all the different scripts. I'm just going to use one I know that works. I'm going to do Yellowtail. And that's just simply from using it a lot. Okay, so I'm liking this. I'm going to turn it a bit. And I'm going to size it up. I am going to reduce the line spacing here so it's not so far apart. And I'm actually going to center this so that the L and the G don't match up as much there. And reduce the line spacing. And I'm going to make this the same gold as the price bar here. Go here, make that gold there. So that stands out from the rest of the text on there. Now I'm going to throw in a full price. Somebody wants to buy the full price. So I'm just going to copy that. I am going to make that white. And I'm going to just say 6,900. Again, it could be whatever price you want. And if somebody sees this a few years from now, they might think, wow, that's a great price. Because everything's probably gone up in price since when I've done this video. So there's 6,900. I am going to get this so I can make a dollar sign and reduce the space there, reduce the size, move that over here. And let's just tweak it a little bit. So sometimes you can do some really close up manual tweaking with your keyboard. So I just select it and started using my arrow keys on my keyboard. Next thing is I'm just going to copy this and I want to say, and I'm going to reduce the size of this because it needs to be a bit smaller. I'm going to put this on one line, make that a lower one. And I'm going to say buy now. And this one I'll make right justified by clicking up here. Oh, why did I do that? It's probably because there's some spacing issues here. We'll select all. We'll do it this way. There we are. So you got this. And let's pull that in a bit. All right. So we've got now it's saying buy now. And what I want to do as well is I want to put an or in here. So that somebody might want to do monthly payments. Somebody might want to do the full price. But first of all, I just don't like how this is lining up. Not as same kind of angle as this, but if I do this, way better. That's better. Now I'm going to throw in an or here. So I'm just going to make a circle. And you can make a circle like this, just with a C. And you go here. I'm just going to make this red. I'm going to pull this over here. Put it right here, probably a bit smaller. There we are. And I am going to take this, put it here. I'm going to write or, size it down, put it in the red circle there. So we've got this or buy now. Now I'm going to put in the warranties. So again, steal that text from there, just copying it. So just to show you what I did again, take that, duplicate, do this. And then I'm going to say 10 year parts. This is way too big. Go in here. I can make it bigger after. Easier to make it bigger than smaller. Let's reduce the line spacing. Pull this in, make it a bit bigger. All right. We like to put the warranties in. People like to see that. So I'm going to duplicate it. And then I'm going to put 2 year labor. Again, these warranties will be whatever you want them to be. I'm just using this as an example. So let's just move this over a bit. Okay. So just by doing this, we've got pretty much a great looking ad already. I'm just going to add a few little bits in here to kind of make it pop a bit more. I want this to be a limited time offer to try to give some, to make people want to take action quicker. So here we go. I've done this before, limited time offer. Here's a nice corner. I'm going to, you can see here, it's trying to pop in there again. I'm going to pull this up here. Put this here like so, maybe a bit smaller. All right, so now we've got limited offer. And then I'm going to put a person down here to kind of surprise person to, again, to draw attention, because people's faces tend to draw attention. So I am going to do a search for surprised woman. And photos, make it look real. Let's just look through here and see what I can find. One that really looks great. There we go. Let's go with her. Put her in here. Again, we can go to edit photo, background remover. Let's just crop this in here a bit so we don't have all this extra bits around it. So if we have to go edit it, it just makes it easier. Let's make it a bit smaller so she's not covering too much of the equipment. There we are. So we've designed this ad really quickly. The important points are tell people what the ad is about right away at the top. Have kind of an offer. You can come up with anything, mega sale, big sale, surprise sale, flash sale, whatever, just to think that, you know, that they need to take action now. Put the pricing in the ad. If you don't put pricing in, there's a lot less chances that this ad will convert. You don't have to necessarily put both payment and full price on here. Either one works. Just did it for this one as an example. Put the warranties in, the equipment. I just put a face here to grab attention. And that's it for really what works for this. And if you want to export it, just go share, you go to download, and then it can be a PNG, can be a JPEG, and just click download, and you've got yourself an ad all ready to go for your heating and air conditioning business, or to put on Facebook, to put on Instagram. So if you like this video, smash that like button. If you want to see more content like this, subscribe. Comment below with some suggestions you'd like to see for us to demo for you. And if you want help with your marketing for your HVAC business, click the link in the description below. Book a consult with us. We can take care of designing all your ads for you. We can take care of running your ads, making sure to get in front of the right people and manage it, because we've done this for hundreds and hundreds of clients across the United States and Canada. So we have so much data, we have so much knowledge about what works. We can help you with this. You don't have to worry about designing this yourself. We'll design it for you. We'll keep changing them out over time. We'll do all that. That's all part of what we do. Again, links in the description below. You can tap to go over to book a time with us, or you can even call or text with the phone number and text that are in the description below. So again, any comments, questions, leave them below. Thanks so much for watching this. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks.